Trying to find a good reference. Trying. Some armor for this guy in his head or something like that. It's hard to actually find anything good. So this is actually a model I made a long time ago, but I always wanted to do some armor for him, so I'm gonna give it a try. Make something a bit like a kind of metal, like pounded thing. I might actually get him into Marmoset first. Just get that out of the way. Because he has pretty decent, like, low poly. But probably no UVs. It looks a bit like Ganon. Chop the head in half, I think. Yeah. We'll see what it does. So plugins, UV master, polygroups, turn symmetry up. That was very fast. check the sky on. So scale master sliders. He's quite small. Usually to like 30. Resize. And then I usually do a unify because it kind of screws up the brush size. It's like really small now. See, you can turn dynamic off, but I don't like doing that. So I usually just do this one and it'll go tiny again, but it'll keep the scale. So when you go back here and hit that, it's still 30. I am going to save this. We'll take the lowest, throw it inside, see. Ahoy. I usually just make polymesh and I'm going to decimate the highest level, and then the high poly will be easier to bake, so we won't be dealing with like millions of triangles. You can see if we go up here just to the cog, we can go show guides or scale reference. Oh, it's still quite small. That's annoying. Thank you. it's important to get the scale right, because it'll affect things like scattering. And I find if it's really big or small, it like just struggles to render. That's better. I call this whack. Do that again. Let's pre-process that decimate again. Have a look in here while it's doing that. Create a bacon node. Set up the texture location. Cool. Let's go back. Still doing it. Give it time. Now. Just mess around with this while it finishes. This part is kind of cool. If you split the viewport here, vertical, and then switch the camera to the line. Can use that to. I used to do this in Maya back in the day with Mental Ray. Like, have your viewport as the camera, and if you like focus it, kind of just makes it easier to pan. It's quite nice. And then in the light, if we just turn off this. Go to the light, and then it's nice to just tweak the diameter, so it'll soften your shadow. This is just super sharp. I'm not sure why that's the default, but just something a little bit softer. And then yeah, this kind of sharpness. Like if you make this really small, you can see. The default is quite sharp again, but I like to soften it or even go like 0.2, and it gives it like kind of quadratic feel. The only problem is you need to amp up the brightness to compensate. See where it's at. Okay. Let's do it again. Good. Save that. And then on the baker, you can switch here. With the main camera, I'm just gonna change that FOV, make it a bit flatter. But yeah, we're looking at the high poly, so we'll hide that, put the low poly. And then actually in the texture node, just put the padding up. But we want to link the material. So we create a new material because the material that comes from ZBrush doesn't work. But it has bugs for some reason. So we can assign it first to here. Control delete kind of clears out any old shader if there was one. And then in the texture, we want to assign it here as well. Boop. And then get rid of that default. So let's just double check it's assigned. Yep. And I'm just wondering to change the workflow away from metalness to specular. So get rid of the metalness. Let's get rid of roughness. Let's add spec gloss. Do like a different workflow. Save this before it crashes. This is actually quite low poly. So I might actually just use not the lowest, but like one up. Because it's quite low poly. Yeah, so I usually just do these two, just so you know how it works. But yeah, I usually just check it before baking everything. Yeah, go back to the baker and just slap these up. Like I said, this is a very old model. I think this was 2015. Teeth level. And the eyes. Whoa. Tracing on. That's better. Hello. Hope you're doing good. Just setting up an orc to make some armor. Some of these materials are quite interesting. They get like a nice effect. So I'm gonna make like a headpiece, I think. Let's give it a go. Using masks to extract. It's kind of like a piece of metal. And I'll just keep doing that until I create the whole thing and then try to sculpt it and just keep using ZRemesh to clean it. Just keep extracting, and it looks kind of bonkers, but oh, did the other side. But it gives you like a quick thing that you can just kind of clean. And a nice trick is just to decimate it sometimes. And then just chunk it really, really small, maybe two. And then it's like super low. Actually, you can do it and keep, like freeze the borders. Do it again. Just kept it like a little bit more sharp, and then when you do this you can detect edges. Oy. So it's kept that like somewhat of a shape. Armor is you don't need to be, because it's like the orc armor from Lord of the Rings, you don't need to be super careful about it. So you're kind of like mash and pound it later. Face it a bit. And I'm just doing this side for placement, because when I polish this one, I'll mirror it, but I just want to see how it looks in terms of like design. It might be nice to do like asymmetric or something with it. This one just wants to be a bit thicker. So under deformation I'll just do a just do the same thing, just extract it. For letting me know. I still have no idea what I'm doing. Yeah, so I'll decimate this down maybe 2. This might be too low. And then see what the remesh does. Let's do the same. It's okay. It's a bit messy, but try a bit higher. See what that does. Yep, that should be okay. Let's just try to go super low now. Maybe lower. Maybe too low. A bit higher. Still trying to keep a hard edge ish. We could do try and polish it. Doesn't like me today. Okay. And I'm just looking at like this orc from Lord of the Rings, kind of just trying to do something similar. Where it has these plates kind of going under and over. And this one like goes into like quite a sharp point. So I'll just flatten it with the planer, as if you're hammering it. Something like that. Good, thanks for confirming. Because, yeah, I really need to figure out what I'm doing with audio. Still learning. Learning the ropes, but thanks for that. I appreciate it. So I'm just going to go around this and just give it a little bit of a massage. And maybe like with these, with these edges, kind of have something like a bit like wobbly that kind of bends around. Something like that, maybe. And then with these, I'll just like do like a clone. A little bit thick. I'm just going to thin them with inflight. Just bring it in a little bit. Now this one, I'm just gonna have it go over the whole thing. Yeah, and I think I'll do one more big piece at the back of the cranium. Extracts. Boop. Decimate it down. I think he needs something more aggressive. So I might give him some spikes. Go here to initialize, could give it a cube. Then do this. Make a shape. Let's make a shape like that, and then just make some little spikes. Maybe one more. Okay, we'll start polishing this. And I'm just gonna use like the clay brush just to kind of sharpen the edge a bit. So it's getting that kind of pounded. Just using the planar, just to pound it down.
it's kind of bending around the palm. So as this big piece goes under, this kind of bends. There's some kind of interesting detail there. I'm using the move topological rather than just the standard move, because I've kind of merged these together now. Thank you. this. If you turn this off, divide, divide, put it back on, divide, divide, you get like a bit more of a nice edge. Surface a bit so it's not too straight. The texture is going to do a lot of the hard work, I think, putting that lots of detail in there.
This is actually gonna work. That's really cool. My goodness. Almost looks like a sand creature. That's really, really cool. You see the tessellation splitting. We can fix that. I'll just just re-export it without polygroups. Just make it all into one group. Come on. Just have to reduce it. Oh, it just updated. There we go. If I put it back on, I wonder if it'll... Yeah, it did fix it. But it looks so crazy because you have to, in the mesh, you have to actually put the, in this group, the subdivide on. Try to give it some more resolution. And then slow. try to refine it, but I'm not gonna. My computer's gonna explode. I'll just keep it off for now. That's really cool. I wonder if I can use that somehow. Yeah, like a desert orc. Because I remember seeing like that dude in Spider-Man. I thought that looked really cool, but I'm getting distracted. I think also scattering is a bit odd. Surface. Oh, no, it's okay. Was making this like weird pattern. It's kind of interesting, could increase that, make it a bit tinier so it feels like skin. Subdivision level of these tools, then I should be able to merge them all into one helmet. Let's see. What's that one got? Five. So then it's kept like the subdivision levels, which is handy because I'm going to use that as the low poly. Down again. glass piece. So now we've got all those. I'm just gonna see what happens when I try to unwrap it for speed. See what that looks like. Oh, there's gonna be a lot of baking errors. Let's just see, just for shits and giggles. Decimate the high and try to make it a bit more manageable. All right, let's try to get this. 500. Maybe. Yep. Teeth are just they need something doing really, but maybe for another time. Helmet attacks, spec, get rid of malness, roughness, add in spec. Make a new material, call it helmet, apply it to the low. Yep. It is applied, and then apply it to the texture. Boink. Get rid of default. And path the texture. Helmet. See if it bakes. Okay. I'm surprised there wasn't more errors. What's that? Now the scattering is wild. It kind of removes all the detail, but it'll come back. And so, let's see if I can find an interesting metal. Let's make him fancy. Scattering is intense. I'm going to turn it off. There we go. Steel. That's a bit better. Aged. I like the rust in the cracks and stuff. This is too much texture. But I wonder. The rust element's pretty good. Let me keep the rust. Take that out. See, this might be good to have, like, when it gets scratched, it exposes some of this material. So, I'll find a different metal. Like, bumpy. So this iron weathered bumpy, if you just turn things off, it might actually be adding like a nice texture. Kind of scale it. But maybe that's too big. But we want like a metal. That's close. And you can try like a different lighting, because sometimes it changes it quite a bit. Especially with the metals, you start to see stuff a bit more. that's kind of interesting, but it wants like so the rust layer in between. But it wants to feel like shiny, a little bit more shiny. But then more break up to that, for that roughness. So then with that other layer, this one. No. Something where, as if it got hit and it exposes the metal underneath. Let's try this one. And then you can add like the mask and then convert that mask. We can convert it to maybe curvature. Let's make it a bit brighter so we can see it. So here you can kind of like then control the mask to kind of increase that intensity. Then as you make it sharper, you're just revealing it on the edges then. But I kind of made it really bright. Maybe like too bright. And then you can sharpen it as well to kind of make it a bit more crisper. Stack, I can try it with a different material, because maybe that one's a bit too similar. If you do like a bronze, paste it, you can kind of see it a little bit more, like just kind of peeking through. See what's going on here. Might add some mud on his body. Thank you. put something on and then kind of what I like to do is group it, add another mask, and then you can just paint it in where you want it, which is quite nice. So it's not just like everywhere. Forever. It's so fun just messing around. Add a few lights just to do something. Thank you.